All right, so what we're going to do is going to be cleaning this corrector plate. It's pretty nasty. It doesn't look as horrendous when you're looking through it that way, but it's pretty bad going when you're looking at it this way. So what we've got is a little bucket that we're going to put some distilled water in, another one that I'm going to put some soapy water in, just a bit of dish soap. We've got our cotton balls that we're going to use, some gloves, and our distilled water from the hardware store. So I'm going to set this up and go through the process. You can see that that's just from a little bit of dabbing that we're just getting off. Just, we're not even starting to wipe, we're just trying to get some of the stuff off first. And we're not using the other side where our fingers are and stuff, so we're just getting in there. So much less is coming off now, but we're going to keep going around just to keep it a bit moist. Okay, I think that's got the majority of the first lot off. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go around now again, just dabbing, because I can still see some dirt just sitting here. And we'll just keep going. And then we'll do the soap version after that. Okay, so we've agitated some soap in here. Just a few drops of dish soap in the water. And so this should dislodge anything that is still sitting there and get rid of any other kind of greasy spots that that may have come from fingerprints over the course of time. Just going to drop the OTA just a smidge, just so the water runs out a little down here. Now, we didn't take off the external retaining clip here. And so there's a seal behind that, so there's not going to be any water that's going to get through anyway, but we're just trying to avoid touching things that we don't need to. So we'll give this a crack. And we're just going to get rid of this because we're going to have to rinse this off anyway, so let's just get rid of the dirt and dust off that. So this is just the cover for the secondary mirror. That's quite filthy. And while we're at it, we might as well go around the inside edge here as well. Alright, so now we're going to rinse off all of the soapy water. Okay, that's looking pretty good. I'm gonna now, after this one, I'm gonna actually use swiping movement now, because I can't see any dust on there anymore. So just going to use a bit of pressure, just virtually none, but now there's no risk of dragging any dirt along there. And these are clean as in this process, but given the whole bag cost me $3 of cotton balls, it's not like I don't care about wasting them. So just drag it very lightly. Now again, I'm probably going a little bit silly with the water and probably putting too much, but given the way I've got it angled, it's dripping off anyway. It's not like it's going to go and sit in anything anywhere. Right, it's looking pretty good. So now I'm going to just do a couple of runs with the soapy water. This time, dragging it along a little. This hopefully should, I think there was one fingerprint on here that I could recall. So this just tiny bit of pressure while I do this should get rid of that as well. Again, there's really nothing happening here anymore. It's a pretty good indication that we are pretty damn clean now. Okay. I'm gonna rinse. All right. I'm gonna now just dry this off a little. Now, there are little bits of fluff coming off here from the cotton, but we're not finished yet, because what we're going to do is we're going to go and use some specially formulated cleaning solution from the telescope shop, which I think has a little bit of a mix of isopropyl alcohol in it as well, so that should help. But regardless, as this all dries off, and obviously run with the alcohol will cause it to evaporate rather quickly, we'll just be able to blow this off with you know, just a blower or something like that, if there's any of these bits of fluff hanging on there. So I gotta go inside and go and grab the cleaning solution. Okay, so what we've got here is the cleaning solution that I bought from Bintel. It's about $15. Not actually sure what's in it exactly, they don't say, but I've had this telescope since before my son was born, so that's like more than 14 years. And I got this right near the beginning, but I have never had the guts to clean the front of it. So, okay, get to use it. It's pretty unlikely that you can see what I'm seeing here, but I can definitely see that it's a different effect than just the water or even the soapy water. It's This is a UHTC cleaning solution, which is ultra high transmission coating, which is built for this type of telescope. So got no idea what the difference is. Could be just a really cool label and that's it, but it definitely is making a difference in terms of what it's doing from a cleaning perspective. It's way different to water and or the soapy water. It's definitely having a different impact. I can readily see the difference between the two. Definitely has a smell of isopropyl alcohol to it. It's not particularly very strong, but definitely has that kind of odor. So outside of a few little kind of streaks as it's drying, but they're going away rather readily. I'm just going to give it a little wipe now with just dry. Alrighty, so now we're done. I think that's a pretty substantial improvement. So, while we're at it, we just might as well have a look and see what the status of this is. Hopefully. Well, it's definitely needs, it's got a little bit of dust on it, but given the fact that the dust cover was on, it's actually fairly likely that that's the dust that's been on it for years. So we'll just give it the same treatment. This is going to be substantially quicker. So this scope up here is a Saxon 80ED. It's primarily used as my guide scope. However, it's pretty good for wide field stuff, or it's reasonably forgiving with a DSLR as well. Can get you some nice wide field stuff like M42. Just makes it a little bit easier to do. It's also, it's a lot nicer to do visual stuff with. Obviously it's way easier to see a lot of things with it, and not as challenging. Oftentimes it's easier to let kids look through the reflector instead. Oh, sorry, the refractor. Just it's a lot more forgiving in terms of having to bend over at weird angles and stuff, so can be a bit easier. Probably should cover up the scope underneath, but I mean, it's gonna get dirty, dusty, and wet, you know, more times in the future. Don't need to be too pristine about it. It's just, you know, they get covered in dew, they're gonna get wet. So we don't need to be all heroic about it, but let's just get some of the main goop off. And, you know, now that I've done the lenses, it'll be way better getting around to cleaning the body on them as well. So also remember that everything we're doing here is primarily just around cleaning up some of the more obvious things. In the overall scheme of life, you're not gonna see, I mean, I could have been looking through it as it originally was and not really noticed much in terms of the image degradation. Like, I mean, we're really, you can quarter occlude this and not even notice. You know, once in a while, a clean is a good idea. But as I said, this is the first time I've cleaned any of this stuff in 14 years. And frankly, I have no idea if the previous owner of it ever cleaned it either. So I'm going to go with, unless there's something pretty horrendous happening, leave it be. Okay. I think we are done for our cleaning. The mirror looks in really good shape. I cannot see any dust in there at all. It's as clean as I've ever seen it, so that's good. I think we'll leave it at that. And while there's still a little bit of daylight, I'll see if I can give the body a bit of a clean. Okay, that's what we've got for our water. $4 at Bunnings.